Soalan pertama daripada Tuan Bonnie. Okey, soalan pertama, go boleh naik atau terus turun? Thank you, cikgu.
Okey, soalan ni we have to go a bit into detail, okay, sebab there is something quite interesting happened last night lepas NFP. So let us go into the chart. Boleh tengok screen eh?
Ya, 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 belum. Okay, done.
Okay, untuk soalan ni, later we come back to what's going to happen next week. Tapi sebelum tu kita tengok gold dulu, okay? Sebab the news, okay, actually it's better I show what happened yesterday, last night. Sebab ada yang tak join masa live trade semalam.
Yes.
So, I actually go quickly. Okay, I focus on this US dollar punya news, okay? The fact that US dollar strengthen malam adalah actually untuk dua elemen ni. Of course malam ataupun minggu lepas saya dah beritahu yang dua elemen ni akan memberi surprises, tapi I'm also a bit quite surprised to see this number to be above 900 plus thousand on this employment change. And second surprise is this number, unemployment to be lower than 5.5%. So this actually caught the market off guard ataupun off hand semalam, because what was market expecting ataupun even myself was expecting was this number to be about 600 or 700,000. Okay, that's one. Okay, and second is I was expecting this to be about 6 to 7%. Okay. So, bila dua-dua ni actually came out, it was showing that actually US economy is recovered or already recovering in a very good manner, okay? Because what it's telling us is the employment, okay, that means people getting back to work ataupun dah masuk balik kerja, is actually increased quite a lot, okay? And second, unemployment, of course, if it's more people coming to work, the unemployment will be a bit lower. So this is why actually there are a couple of lessons we can learn, okay? Sometimes whatever the market is predicting or some rumors that coming in, we cannot take it also as I put it quote unquote like a, it's a orang putih cakap it's like a apa kata?
Okay,
something is a gospel truth or something, okay? But this is where we actually have to take any news, any analysis coming from even from the market or CNBC or Bloomberg, we have to take with a pinch of salt, okay? Because market was expecting these numbers to be lower, that means in a red color lah, okay? But turns out to be it's quite strong, okay? This actually puts US dollar strength a bit higher. Let's say even market was expecting only about 10-20% strength. I'm just talking about the relative term first, but because of this data, it actually pushed up almost 2 times or 3 times higher. Okay, so this is why you guys saw gold was dropping almost about $40 from 1,800, but you guys didn't see too much of that impact in EU or GU, although other impact they turun about 40-50 pips, something like that. But still it's declining trend, but it's not as orang kata volatile as gold punya movement, okay, because of these two employment results. Okay, so I go back to the chart. Okay, so first we look at the daily, okay, like what we were saying previously, 1810 and 1800 was the support. If it holds, then we expecting to go up. Then during NFP, we expect to come down. Okay, but what happened was from 1840 to drop to 1800, it's about $40 drop we expecting, but it actually didn't go up to drop. It was dropping from 1810 punya zone, and then it was dropping. Initially, dia naik atas sampai about 1820 or 1830 punya zone. Then after that, ada rejection. Okay? So, kalau pergi dekat 4 hourly, we saw there was an attempt to move up around 1830, but didn't go up. Okay, and then it was dropping, and then 1810 was holding for a while, and 1805 was another key support. Was actually market was hoping for, but even that one was broken before NFP. So we were expecting 1800 will be holding during NFP. Just before NFP, they cuba naik ke atas, but then the moment the data came out, it went down to about 1790. Okay, ataupun sebelum tu dia pergi 1794, cuba naik balik. So we were expecting kalau US dollar was weaker, then it will go up again to up before move down and then strengthen. Tapi because US dollar was quite strong, dari 1800 they broke 1790, and you are expecting 1790 will be a key support. It tried to hold it for a couple of minutes, then it broke, and then you are expecting 1780 1775, somewhere that zone dia akan hold. Tapi dia tak hold, dia break, dia pergi dekat 1770. So we were thinking 1770 will be holding because there was a previous support dekat situ. Even that support, it broke, it went to almost 1758 malam tadi, and then ada rebound sedikit about 1765, and then now holding about 1763 lah.
Okay, so now the question,
tadi siapa tanya tu? Bonnie ya? Eh? Okay.
Yes, Tuan Bonnie.
Whether, okay, gold will rebound or hold it. Okay, first look at the bigger time frame. Okay, daripada picture like this, from just pure naked chart, okay, we can clearly see the previous support was somewhere 1750, pernah pergi ke sini. Okay, so there is a chance that it might go to 1750 baru naik ke atas. Okay, tapi nampak macam semalam punya rebound. Okay, if you see on the 15 minute time frame, we are trying to see somewhere a range bound. Okay, sama ada dia akan break out ataupun ke bawah. So kalau tanya saya, I'm expecting at least dia buat somewhere dekat 1770 atau 1775 before going down. Macam siapa yang pernah trade, I think about 3 or 4 weeks ago, a month ago, you guys probably have seen it. This trend was happening somewhere masa time dia turun ni. I think somewhere dekat sini, about couple of months ago. Yeah, one part it was somewhere dekat sini. Okay, dia cuba naik, and then dekat 1797, I think it wasn't cannot go up, and then they crash dekat sini. And second time it was ranging quite for a long period time dekat sini, and then go down to 1750, lepas tu baru naik ke atas. So it might do this pattern again
somewhere here. That means
dia boleh turun ke, naik ke atas, and then turun bawah, naik ke atas, turun bawah. That means it might range between 1770, okay, and might go down to about 1755, and might spike down a bit to 1750 before try to reach again this 1800, okay, ataupun 1790 punya level. Okay, so this part might take maybe 1-2 weeks. Macam dulu dia pernah buat dekat sini. Okay, so this might happen sebab after a strong move, it can have some range bound for about 1-2 weeks. Similarly, kat sini kalau nampak ada range bound kat sini. Okay, or it might be this kind of a break, pergi bawah lagi. But again, at this point, this move we don't expect sebab dia ada satu trend line support that's coming up upwards somewhere this zone. Okay, I don't think it will be a strong breakout this trend line. Okay, so the expectation is it might do this range bound for short period of time before goes up or break down, then
go up, bearish flag,
and then go down again to this level. Okay, so to summarize it, if I go to H4, okay, apa yang boleh berlaku, if you ask me, it might go up a bit to 1770 September 1775, create a bit of a bearish flag, and then come down, test 1750, go up again, okay, and then make another lower high, and then break. That means the trend will be following some kind of this channel. Okay, so this movement is looking like more probable for gold right now. But in the bullish trend, as long as they maintain below 1800, okay, it looks like more of a bearish trend. Okay, if it breaks this 1800, 1810, the movement katakan tiba-tiba dia berlaku, contohnya lah, dia pergi ke atas, turun bawah, dia pergi ke atas, turun bawah, then dia break, then the trend become bullish. Okay, tapi kalau dia sampai sini, worst case, okay, dia pergi ke bawah, then this will be a more of a bearish trend. Okay, so I'm looking at it more sekarang ni, dia buat satu flag, cuba buat lower high somewhere kat sini ataupun somewhere kind of worst case and turun bawah. Tapi for the time being, I will say maybe for 1 week, it might be a bit range bound. Tapi later, ataupun kejap lagi, okay, so I show Forex Factory, ada data ni, okay. Next week, there is a CPI data. So this might change kita punya analisa. So it depends on the magnitude yang data keluar kat sini. This CPI. Okay, for example, this inflation, okay, is a bit lower. Okay, maybe let's say 0.1%, but very unlikely. Okay, CPI, then it might mean, might be good for US dollar. Tapi kalau katakan tiba-tiba data ni become about 0.7 ataupun 0.9, then US dollar will be, orang kata, a bit weaker lah. Okay, but inflation when this data, because inflation is very high, okay, very likely Fed might intervene. Maybe this data will prove that inflation is non-transitory, but it's actually real, okay, then the market might react, okay, Federal Reserve might taper a bit earlier, ataupun interest rate akan dinaikkan cepat, then we might see US dollar become stronger, okay, but if this data is actually about 0.3 ataupun 0.5, okay, then US dollar will be still not so strong. That means ada chances untuk gold untuk rebound balik. Okay, it's a long explanation on gold. Okay, but that's how it looks like currently lah. Chances to become strong bullish again a bit low. Okay, but it looks like more of a bearish trend. Tapi daripada zone ni, dia ada chances dia pergi bawah sedikit baru buat retracement. So whatever you guys might see will be a retracement. You might not see strong pull like this, okay? It will be a more of a range bound and then goes up and then very likely to come down again ataupun pergi ke atas and then come down again. Unless something else changes in the market dynamic lah, okay? So itu saja, Bun.
Okay, baik.